Welcome to Critical Navigation. I'm your host, Andrew, and today we're going to be taking a look at the tragic story of the RMS Queen Elizabeth. So in 1936, the John Brown and Company had started construction on a massive ship. This ship was going to be named the Queen Elizabeth. The Queen Elizabeth would be the largest ship in her time. She was so massive that she beat the size of the biggest ship at that time, the Queen Mary. The Queen Elizabeth was 1,031 feet long and 118 feet wide, and she would weigh in at over 83,000 tons. She was launched in 1938, only 2 years after construction started, and she was the largest ship that the world had ever seen. The Queen Elizabeth was used as a troop ship during World War II, and she was one of the few ships to make it out without sinking. After the war had ended, she had entered the transatlantic service of the White Star Line in 1946. The Queen Elizabeth was one of the nicest ships in her time. She had amazing interior fit with all of the modern and expensive furniture. She had featured the nicest bars, lounges, rooms, and more. However, in the early 1960s, the ocean liner industry began to collapse. Since planes had become the preferred way of making transatlantic journeys, ocean liners weren't really needed anymore, and the Queen Elizabeth had retired from the ocean liner industry in 1968. She had made her final crossing to New York on December 8, 1968, and was sold to the Cunard line. When she was sold, she was moved to Port Everglades, Florida, and had been converted into a tourist attraction. However, the business was unsuccessful, and she closed in August of 1970. All hope had seemed lost for the Queen Elizabeth until she had gone to be refitted in Hong Kong. However, that's when tragedy struck. On January 8th, the Queen Elizabeth had caught on fire and began to burn. Despite the entire Hong Kong firefighting force trying to save it, there was no hope. The Queen Elizabeth had burned for 2 days when she turned on her side and sank. After the ship had sank, all that was left was the shell of the once mighty ocean liner. No one had known what had caused the fire of the Queen Elizabeth, however, the court had ruled that it was caused by an unknown arsonist. Not long after the ship had sank, the Queen Elizabeth had been declared a shipping hazard and was dismantled for scrap. And 2 years after the sinking of the Queen Elizabeth, the once mighty ship was no more. And that, my friends, is the story of the Queen Elizabeth. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and I'll see you next time. I'm your host, Andrew, signing out.